Welcome to General Biology Laboratory. Today we will be discussing microscopes. Objectives. Today we will learn about the basic components of the dissecting and compound microscopes. We will learn which types of microscopes are best for viewing specific types of specimens. We will learn how to calculate the magnification power of the compound microscope. And we will learn about the concepts of field of view, depth of field, and resolution. Different types of microscopes. Today, we will discuss the following types of microscopes: the dissecting microscope, the compound microscope, the scanning electron microscope, or SEM, and the transmission electron microscope, or TEM. These are some of the important features of the dissecting microscope: the ocular lenses, or eyepieces, the 2X lens screwed onto the objective, the mirror, the base, the arm, the mirror tilt adjustment knob, the focusing knob, and the magnification changing knob. The stereoscopic or dissecting microscope is considered a simple microscope because it contains only one lens. Properties of the dissecting or stereoscopic microscope are: they reflect light from the surface of a specimen. They provide a three-dimensional image. They have a maximum magnification power of 300x, and they are best for viewing parts of a specimen or entire organisms. The compound microscope contains two lenses. One lens is in the oculars, and the other lens is in the objective. Here are the important features of the compound microscope: the eyepieces, the objectives, the stage, the light adjustment knob, the base, the movable stage control, the fine focus knob, the coarse focus knob, the arm, and the rotating nose piece. The properties of the compound microscope are as follows. They transmit focused light through a specimen on a fixed slide. They provide a two-dimensional image. They have a maximum magnification power of 2000x. They are best for viewing small specimens such as cells, tissues, and some bacteria. The scanning electron microscope, or SEM. Ordinary non-confocal light microscopes are limited to magnifications of up to 2000x. Electrons have wavelengths that are 100,000 times shorter than visible light. This means that an electron microscope has the ability to magnify a specimen by 100,000 times. Properties of the scanning electron microscope, or SEM. They use an electron beam that is bounced off a specimen coated with gold. They provide a three-dimensional image. They produce an image that is usually in black and white. They can magnify a specimen up to 100,000 times. They are best for viewing the external features of microscopic objects. Here is a bee coated in gold for viewing with a scanning electron microscope. The transmission electron microscope, or TEM, works by transmitting a beam of electrons through the specimen. Whatever part is transmitted is projected onto a phosphor screen for the user to see the specimen. The properties of the transmission electron microscope are as follows. An electron beam is sent through an ultra-thin slice of a specimen. They provide a two-dimensional image. They can magnify a specimen up to 100,000 times. And they are best for viewing the internal features of microscopic objects. Let's see what happens when we view a comic strip taken from a newspaper through the dissecting microscope. When you observe the comic strip with the naked eye, the colors and shapes appear to be solid. When you observe the comic strip with the dissecting microscope, it becomes clear that the colors and shapes are actually made up of tiny dots with white space between them. This phenomenon is called resolution. The resolution of an optical microscope is defined as the shortest distance between two points on a specimen that can still be distinguished by the observer or camera system as separate entities. Calculating magnification. How to calculate the magnification used when viewing a specimen with the compound microscope. In a compound microscope, the magnification is going to be determined by the magnification of the objective used, as well as the magnification of the eyepieces, which are 10x. That means when you view a specimen with the eyepieces only, the specimen appears to be 10 times larger than with the naked eye. In addition to the eyepieces, we must also consider the magnification of the objective used. To know the magnification of the objective, you will simply need to observe the magnification power that is indicated on it. For example, here is a 4x objective, a 10x, a 20x, and a 40x objective. In order to calculate the total magnification, you will need to multiply the magnification of the objective you are using by 10 for the magnification power of your eyepieces. For example, using your 4x objective, your specimen will appear 400 times larger than with the naked eye. Using the 10x objective, your specimen appears 100 times larger than with the naked eye. A specimen appears 200 times larger if you're using the 20x objective, and 400 times larger if you are using the 40x objective. Field of view. Let's see what would happen if you looked at this slide of the lowercase letter e under the compound microscope. With the naked eye, you should see the entire letter E in its correct orientation, like this. Let's compare this with what we see under the microscope using the 4x objective. Under the low magnification of 4x, you will be able to see all of the letter E. The entire letter E is in the field of view. However, your E will be upside down, like this. As you increase in magnification, your field of view will be getting smaller. Eventually, you will get to the point where you can only see a portion of your letter E. For example, under the 40x objective, you will only be able to see about this much of your letter E. objects appear dimmer in smaller fields of view. You may notice you need more light as you increase in magnification. This is because as the field of view gets smaller, less light is reaching your eye. Depth of field. Depth of field refers to how much of the specimen is in focus. The depth of field decreases with increasing resolution and increasing magnification. When this slide is viewed at low power, it is difficult to distinguish which thread is on top. This is because lower magnification has a longer depth of field, and each thread appears to be in focus. However, when this same slide is viewed at high power, you can focus on each thread individually. This allows you to distinguish the order of the threads on the slide. Let's review. Today we learned about the basic components of the dissecting and compound microscopes. We learned which types of microscopes are best for viewing specific types of specimens. We learned how to calculate the magnification power of the compound microscope. And we learned about the concepts of field of view, depth of field, and resolution. Thank you for watching.